Sometimes, but although my meat, although my day, and it is not the patients. Who's a patient? So, although my day, and not too long. Yes.
Can your blood type actually determine your personality? Let's talk about that.
Good mythical morning.
Okay, so the other day we were in a meeting, you were talking.
When you're on the lock screen of your phone where you have to enter in the code to access the phone, there's an emergency button, which I already knew about that, so you can then dial 911 in the case of an emergency.
And I see over here in the lower left-hand corner, medical ID. Click on that, and it's got my name, but no other information. I have since filled out things like my birthday, my
emergency contact.
I am an organ donor, but it has a place for blood type, and it hit me. I have no idea what my blood type is. I could be in some kind of accident, and I need to get like a new ear or something, and they're not going to know which ear to give me because I don't know my blood type.
Well, that's your ear type.
This is important.
Yeah. Do you know your ear type?
Lobed, detached.
That's probably left or right.
I don't care, as long as it matches something.
You don't want to put a right ear on the left side.
But I actually found that you can...
Oh, you're good, too. Alright, so did you enjoy the coffee?
Yes.
The coffee tastes really different from Taiwan's. I still cannot get used to it, especially the milk tea. The milk tea, it tastes a little bit interesting, actually. No, I don't think so. No. The milk tea here is so sweet. Yeah. I have to go with a lot of water, you know. Alright, so I just want to make sure because I still haven't got invitation from some groups about their slides. Okay, I only got group 3, group 5, group 6, group 9, and group 11. One? Send me the invitation as well? All right. Okay, so are we getting ready for our second section of our workshop? Okay, let's see. Now you're all connected to the internet, and my connection is getting slower and slower. No, that's okay. All right. Okay. So what I'm going to ask you to do is that we are going to review all these questions from different groups. Okay. And let's try to be the judge and see how can those questions can be improved. Okay. How can we try to make amendments to our questions and try to meet our different students' needs. All right, so now I would like to take a look at from the group number one. Okay, we're number one. Okay, so now let's take a look at the first question. Okay, would you like to introduce your question and why you want to come, why you come up with this kind of question? Anyone? Leaders or? All right, I'll pass you the. Okay.
We come up with different kind of questions, as you can see. The first one, like, which blood type do you likely to have if you like drawing? Because they can get the answer quite easily from, you know, by referring to the passage. And also, we have some open-ended ones. Not really. The number. Okay.
The question two.
No. It should be somewhere right here. I guess the last one.
Last one?
Yeah, like this one. If you could change your blood type, which type would you like to have?
Oh, right.
Yeah,
attention to this. I noticed this question. This is a very good question, all right? Okay, if you could change. So what do you expect from your students?
I guess they can have like a group discussion, and they can talk about their answers freely, which is to test their creativity, and also it's just like a free, you know, question without definite answers.
Yeah. Okay. So how can we improve? How can this question be improved? Any ideas? Can we get a better idea to improve this question and to make it a deeper thought, to provide a deeper thought for our students? Can anyone? And do you have any idea? How can this question be improved? I mean to make it a question. What words are you going to add into this question? Any idea?
Like with reference to the passage, if you could choose.
Okay. That's one of them, right? And what else? Well, usually when I try to ask my students, I will give them some kind of specific information. Okay, for example, which type would you like to have? Please to share at least 3 reasons. Things like that. You know what I mean? All right. Okay. So you have to be quite specific, especially for those students who are not used to thinking. Okay. You have to give them some kind of very words to follow, and they will come up with some kind of answer you might not expect. Okay. So if based on this question, I think. If we can add some words like please give at least three reasons. And sometimes I also ask my student the question I will give my students is something like please write down write a short paragraph at least in 50 words. Things like this, and they will just follow, and a student will count their words. Okay, 他们就真的会去数. And sometimes when they are trying to present their answers, and the other students will count their words. And if their answer is less than 50 words, and they will raise their hand and say, it's not me the standard. Okay, so it's kind of fun here. All right, so do you want to share some more questions? Because I noticed that there's a lot of interesting question in your group discussion. Okay, so for example, this one is the same. Is it fair to or reliable to classify people according to their blob type? Still, you can still add some words like please give at least three examples or three reasons, things like that, okay? It's going to be make the questions more specific. Okay, I don't know. What do you think about this question? To what extent do you agree that blob type defined a person? How do you find this question? Is it easy to answer or is it hard to answer? Hard. Why? Yes. Oh, okay, it's meant to be hard. Good, because our students need to be challenged, right? Okay, but what if I want to apply this question, I want the other students to try their best to answer this question. How can we make it an easier one? To help more students to appreciate this question and give them the chance to be willing to try to answer. What can we try to, how can we modify this question? Any idea? It's really hard. It's not an easy job, right? Sure. Okay.
Just to narrow the.
Oh, yes, very good. And give reason.
Yeah.
All right, well, yeah, that's right. Okay, you provide choices, okay, to make your students to follow. At least they have a certain kind of direction to follow. Okay, that's a very good idea. Okay, good. That's really good. Okay, so any other question you would like to share with student teachers? Sorry? Okay, for example, this question. Some student might be just answering yes or no. Okay, so sometimes they will just say, oh, okay, do people in our country share similar belief? Yes, so what do you expect them to, yeah, so you have to have some kind of support in supportive information for them to try to come up with to meet to become desirable, right? So this question can also be modified a little bit. So what do you think? Anyone? Any idea? You see, when I was thinking all by myself, I never have to spend so much time wondering. But so this is the benefit that we share with each other a different kind of, from different aspects to think about the same question. So it's really, it's not an easy job, right? So, any idea? Do you have any idea how we can modify this question? In which country? In which country? Because there are so many countries in the world, yeah, it's really hard. So how about in Hong Kong? Do people in Hong Kong? Okay, in Hong Kong, or how about if we try to relate this question to students' daily life? Maybe we can say, how about your class? Okay, how about your classmates? Okay, how about do your classmates share similar beliefs? Okay, and then students can try to relate this question more to their own experiences, okay? Because I know some youngsters they love this topic a lot, okay? So maybe we can narrow down the people to your classmates, okay? It must be a little bit easier for different students to keep digging in this question, all right? Okay, so this question is good, okay? It's very good. So this is, actually, I don't attach the photo to the question, okay? All right, but yeah, that's okay. Okay, this one is good. Okay, this one is good. Okay, it's very specific, okay? You want to be specific, that's easy. You just offer some kind of numbers, okay, and the student can follow, okay? Okay, this is one. A lot of groups share the same question here. Now, good. All right. So this is number one. Okay. Thank you so much. 我们给他一个掌声，好不好？ All right. They did a very good job. Okay. Good. Thank you. All right. Now let's take a look at group three. Oh, this one is good. What do you think? Do you think there are good blood types and bad types? Explain. Okay, explain. Still, I would say please give at least two or three reasons why you think there's a good blood type and a bad type. Okay, yeah, that's good. And how has Dr. Believe it been used in Japan? Okay, this is specific. Again, students can find the answer from the article, right? So this kind of question is meant for those students whose proficiency, English proficiency is not that good. Okay, so this is also a very good question for those students. Can you think of wrong numbers? Oh, this one is good too, right? So what do you think? Okay, because later you are going to answer this question. Okay, so you have to take a closer look into these questions. Okay. Okay, what my brain. Okay, all right. Okay, this is also a very information-based question, okay, because they can find all the answer and the information from the article. This is a very typical question. And students find this kind of a question a little bit easier to handle, okay? So they feel a little bit secured when they are faced with this kind of question. So this is also a good question in a series of questions. What type of steroids used in sports? All right, so you can see how different teachers can come up with their own questions. So that's the benefit of collaborate together in the future. Mm-hmm. Good, right? Okay, this is very specific too. In paragraph four, in paragraph two, in line 10 or in line 12. Okay, this kind of information will guide your student to the place where you want to find their answers. So this is also very helpful when you try to give more specific instruction in your questions. Okay, this one is good. Okay, especially when your student don't know which blood type you have, this is going to be a very good question for and you might also can have a kind of hold a kind of competition and encourage your students to take a wild guess and to see if they can get the right answer. All right, but please don't give your students the right answer. Okay, this is about the same. Okay, this is about the politician, right? Okay, this one it might be, okay. Why? The same, give at least three reasons, okay? So students can follow. Okay, not bad, right? Okay, this is about the same. All right, so this is number three. Okay, 我们给他掌声, 不错, okay, now let's take a look. Wow, this is cool. It must be group five. Ah, okay, 女生的就不一样, 对不对? Okay, 好了,我们看看。 Okay, this one is easy, right? 这就是给那个比较 low performance student, okay, so for those students, this kind of this kind of question can get your students to have a feeling of secured feeling. So this one is good too. Okay, this is A, B, C. Okay, type C. Do we have type C? Or in the article, did I mention type C? No, I mean, is it A, B? Oh, and A, B, right? Type C. That's it. It reminds me of some of the news connection. Okay, so the type C. What is your blood type? Okay, how about this question? How can we modify it? Because students will just come and say, my blood type is A. So what else? Okay, so can anyone give any suggestion how to modify this, to make this a question more for our students to be able to elaborate a little bit more? Anyone? Anyone? What is your type? What is your blood type? Does it bother you in your daily life? In what way? Yeah, things like that, okay? And what else? Oh yeah, that's right. Okay, yes, right, yeah. Does it match the description in the article, right? Okay, good. Okay, so actually, what is your type? This kind, it gives the right direction because when student, when you talk about, when you mention your blood type, students will become more interested because you are talking about themselves, right? Okay, so they will be more interested in this kind of question, but you have to give more information for your student to elaborate on this question. Okay, so this one is not bad too. Have you ever compared your blood type with others? Yes, I have. So what else? What else do you want, do you expect from your student to answer this question? What else? Have you ever compared your blood type with your others? And what else? How can you modify this question? Anyone? How can you offer more information and to make this question a more with more room for your student to elaborate on? Have you ever compared your blood type with others? Anyone, Janet? Angela? So sometimes our brain just goes blank all of a sudden, all right? So it happens all the time. So at this moment, at a moment like this, when I was at home, I would try to seek help from those golden liquid, and it helps a lot. All right, so have you ever compared your blood type with others? Okay, is it always true, or does it work out all the time? Okay, things like that, all right. This is a hard question to modify. Okay, let's see the next one. What is given in the article? Where the belief affects politics, okay? This is about the same question that you just mentioned before. Okay, and how about in Hong Kong? Okay, make a comparison between blood type in Japan and in Hong Kong. Make a comparison, okay? Can try to expand this question a little bit deeper. Kindergarten teachers? This is interesting. I think only Japanese can make a questions like this, right? Okay, good. One example. You can also try to give two examples. That will be just fine. Okay, it depends on your student's ability. Okay, this one. Oh, yeah. These two questions. Actually, you can combine these two questions into one. Okay? A good example, determine and do not determine. Okay? And maybe you can just combine these two questions together and to offer those more able students this kind of challenge, okay? Okay, this one is try to find a definition of blood type harassment. Okay, why or why not? I love this kind of questions. Okay, why or why not? You offer your students a choice to choose between from different aspects. Why or why not? This kind of question is also good too. Okay? Okay, we all know the results, right? The same. Okay, this one is also good, right? For example, very specific, two negative effects. Okay, so students, they can find the information from the article as well. And also, if you want to make expand this question a little bit more, you can try can you come up with your own? Okay, can you come up with your own negative effects or your own positive effects like that? And student, they will try to come up with their own answer. And this is kind of a little bit can help our student to develop different kind of thinking skills. Okay, and this is specific too. All right. Okay, thank you very much. This is Group 5, right? Okay, 我们掌声鼓励一下啊，这是 Group 5。好 ，Okay, now this is Group 6. Let's see Group 6. Let's see. Okay, blood type. Okay. Okay, this is good. All right. So, student, what do you expect from your student? Oh, would you? Sorry. All right. Mhm. Okay. Is that it? Okay. Okay. Now, let's go. Okay. Okay. Good. All right. So, how about this one? Two examples. Can students find the answer from the article?
Yeah.
All right, good. Typical question, right? And I give two. Okay, this is the same. The same just like the one in the other group. Okay, same question. So sometimes we if we follow the same way of thinking, we can come up with the same question, the same questions. And it happens all the time. Okay, the same? The same? Mm-hmm. All right, this one is interesting. Okay, this one. Okay, would you like to talk about it?
Well, we just ask them if they, like, if you want to, when they grow out, will they want to consider, like, what kind of job they would take according to their blood type?
Mm-hmm.
And they can give reasons whether they will put into consideration. Because they've read some examples from the past.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Okay, very good. Okay, this is and create a new. Oh, right. I love this kind of question. Would you like to talk about it? This is, I love this kind of question a lot.
We've got A, B, A, B, and O.
Okay.
Like maybe they can create a new blood type, like
good.
Z or Z, and they can decide like what temperament or personalities will that person have if they have that kind of blood type.
This is a very interesting question. Do you think so? Yeah, they said, and I think this kind of question is meant for those students with very good English proficiency, right? Okay, this is a very good question. If I use this question in my class, do I have to pay you? All right, good. All right, so that's about the same. All right. Okay. All right. I really love this question. Okay. This one is a very good question. All right. Okay. 我们给我们的第六组啊，掌声给我们的 very good job. Okay. Thank you so much. All right. So now the last one, the last group. Now let's take a look at that. Hands.Okay, we have to wait a little bit. Okay, here. Oh, It's getting slower. Okay, there's something wrong with the connection. Connected? Alright, so, okay, here. How does the author feel about the important? Okay, which group is this? Oh, it's group 9. Would you please pass the microphone to group 9? Alright, would you like to talk about the first question? What kind of students is this question meant for?
What type of student?
Yeah, I mean,
what
that
type. Secondary school, or maybe university, somewhat, I think.
Really?
Higher level, maybe? Because it's about an opinion. And I just want to see if, because in the last paragraph of the article, it really shows what the author really thinks. And
mm-hmm.
I just want to see if students pick up on it.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Okay. So let's take a look at question number 2. It's not responding at all. Why do you ask this question? Do you come up with this question from the Oregon?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because the Japanese leader that got.
He resigned. He blamed his blood type for his for whatever mistakes that he made. So it would be a fun discussion question to argumentative question, kind of to or against what they think. Whether it could be valid or not.
Mm-hmm.
Like, oh, if these are your character traits, would it make you a worse leader if this were true?
Mm-hmm.
If your blood type B. Like, could it, if having these character traits, would that actually make you a bad leader? Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Why? If no, why not?
All right.
I don't know. It was just for fun.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
Okay, good. All right, now let's take a look at this one. Pros and cons. Okay, this kind of question is quite helpful to help our students to sort out some kind of maybe controversial.
Yeah.
Controversial stuff? Okay, so this is also a very good
so
question.
They can break it down.
Yes,
into
exactly.
Smaller parts.
Yeah, that's right. Okay, this is a very good question too. And how about this one? It's about the same, right?
Yeah, we've already covered the
yeah, yes.
Last group.
Yes. Okay. But any question? Okay, this is...
Okay, so...
Yep.
Yeah.
Is it this one?
Yeah.
Which one would you like to share with the other teachers?
Maybe the second last two or the.
Which one?
This one.
Oh, this one.
I think this is just interesting to,
mm-hmm.
to do, like because. Because you can break apart what is a fact and what is superstition or mass belief of the wrong thing.
All right.
So I think that's what the lesson could be about if you keep digging deeper and
yes,
deeper
exactly.
and deeper. And then the last one after this would be an exercise that
mm-hmm.
I would teach with this topic. So maybe
good.
not all in one lesson, that's too
yeah.
heavy, but
mm-hmm.
if you keep wanting to go down deeper and deeper, then I think it comes down to what is fact, what is superstition, and you're going to talk about discrimination.
Yeah, sure.
So
it's getting more and more serious, right?
Yeah.
If you keep digging it. Okay, good.
So the last one, I think, is the extension.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I think that's a pretty fun exercise.
Yes, it is.
Let's go.
Mm-hmm. It reminds me of a video I watched the few weeks ago. It's about, I think it's from Sweden or something like that, telling people, trying to ask them different question, and they were set them apart, and in the end they just come together because they have been bullied before or something like that.
I think you're talking about the one where they ask them where are they from, and they come off a little racist.
They do a genealogy test,
and then all the white people have a little black in them, and then they're like, oh, wow, blew my mind.
Exactly. All right. Okay, so is there any interesting question you would like to share with the others? Any more questions? No? All right, okay, thank you very much. 让我们掌声鼓励一下好了，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢。 All right, so as you can see, we teachers can offer our questions so different from each other's, all right? So what we are going to do next is that I want you to, every teacher, you just answer, try to answer your, you just give yourself, you just come up with different questions, right? Now I want you to answer the question. Okay, you just pick up any question, just one, and then we will draw lots. And we are asked to ask one of you to come up here and try to present your idea and share your answer with the others. And in the meantime, I will ask another teacher to be the teacher and to ask the students further questions. Do you know what I mean? Okay, I'll stay here and I'll share my answer and present my answer to all of you, and one of you will just stand behind and try to interact with the students. Do you know what I mean? All right? Okay, so we'll just give it a try. So I'll just give you maybe 10 minutes. Is that good enough? 10 minutes. Okay, let's go.
Yeah, any questions? group AQ is AT. Alright, so we have 4 minutes to go.
Maria, sorry, because the laptop is not working properly. I cannot do anything about that. It hangs.
I will send you a gift from Taiwan, definitely. But you have to leave your address to me. Alright? Anyone? Oh. I've been to a lot of
Any volunteer who wants to come up to be the presenter and who wants to be the teacher to guide the students and to try to dig out more from the students. Yeah? Anyone want to give it a try? And leave me your address. I mean it. I really mean it. Anyone? And the gift I prepared for you is that it's a notebook from Google. And you cannot buy it because it's only for group leaders and certified and a certificate and a certified. Alright, good, that's good. Okay, very good. Group one, which question? Question? Group one, question nine. And who wants to be the teacher? Both of you will get gifts from me. Anyone? Alright, good. Thank you very much. Okay, wait a minute. Okay, I'll just turn off the other to make sure they're.
So what a relief for the other teachers, right? Do you mind if I take a picture? Whoever represents? No, I mean I can take a picture.
Oh, okay.